start with, I am not getting paid by Insurance Box. I don't get any discounts from Insurance Box for this video. In fact, I get absolutely nothing from them at all except for a insurance box and an insurance premium that I have to pay. So, now that that's out of the way, let's start the video. We needed to get new comprehensive car insurance. So, looking around, Insurance Box seemed to offer one of the best prices. It has a bit of a catch though. As the name suggests, it uses a little box, basically, that plugs into your car that monitors your driving habits and the times you're driving, whether you're speeding or not, where you're keeping your car, how often you're driving, all of that sort of thing. And it uses that to then determine your premiums. And you pay your first premium up front anyway, which is based on apparently average driving habits and all that sort of thing. And that premium is one of the best ones that I've found, particularly with only a $100 excess. It's very, very competitive and cost effective for comprehensive car insurance compared to all the other ones I've seen here in Australia. Now, this insurance box, I was a little bit unsure about whether I really wanted to do that to start with, because do I really want to be sharing with an insurance company where I'm driving? Seems like a bit of a privacy concern, let alone how I drive. I mean, I think I'm a pretty good driver personally, but nevertheless, do I really want to be giving them that sort of data? But besides the fact that it was one of the cheapest to start with, we are really trying to keep costs down, so if it can make our premiums even cheaper, that is a pretty good incentive. But that aside, it occurred to me that with my phone, a lot of this data is already being tracked anyway. But there's a lot of things that the cloud already knows. And while yes, that is a little bit concerning, that, I don't know, I guess to me that does away with some of the additional concerns of giving that sort of data to a insurance company. The other aspect of it though, and the bit that really, I guess, kind of convinced me to give it a try, is they don't just take that data and use it to come up with some arbitrary insurance premium figure. They actually provide a dashboard website that you can log into, and you can see your driving habits on there. You can look at the data, you can see whether you're speeding frequently, you can see whether you don't necessarily brake as smoothly as you should be, or whether you're accelerating too hard, whether you're driving at night a lot, all of that sort of thing. So to me, I thought, well, there are some other benefits to knowing that. I mean, the more efficiently you're braking, the less wear on brakes and tires and that sort of thing. The more efficiently you're accelerating, the less fuel you're using and the less likely you are to be braking harshly as well. As Insurance Box puts it, it's kind of making you more aware of your driving and helping to make you a better driver. Now, whether you actually are a better driver or not, I don't know. But I thought we'd give it a try. Discussed it with my wife, and yeah, so we decided to go ahead with it, see how it goes, give it a whirl for a year. If we don't like it, well, we don't have to stay with it. Now, one of the caveats to be aware of is Insurance Box does charge you a fee for the insurance box that plugs into your car. Now, to start with, when I was reading through their website, it didn't really indicate that. also a $49.95 fee built into your initial premium for the box, which is supposed to be a one-time fee. So it's the website to me was not as clear as it could have been. Perhaps I just wasn't looking at the right places. But anyway, so that aside, that was actually included, the cost of the box, in the initial premium quote anyway. So it wasn't like it was an extra cost that took us by surprise. Now, we signed up. About a week later, we got this in the mail, this little box, along with information on how to install it. Now, inside here, we have some more instructions on how to install, as well as this little box, the insurance box. Now, this little box, the lights aren't on to start with. That's only because I've already had it plugged into the car. Pulled it out again. It basically then plugs into the OBD port in your car, so you have to have a new enough car to have one of those. To my understanding, most new cars do. So once you've got it, you then go and hook it up. And once you've hooked it up to your car, and it has charged the battery in this thing up a little bit, you will get an email from Insurance Box with login details to access your dashboard. After it was about 24 hours for me, your driving data begins to be displayed. And of course, when you decide to cancel your Insurance Box policy, or if you decide to cancel it, or whatever it might be, if you're not happy, etc., they do include this handy return address, postage paid, envelope, satchel thing for you to stick the box back into and return it to them. That's so thoughtful. Unfortunately, I guess it means you've kind of got to keep this satchel somewhere, or at least take note of the details to send it back later. I hope you found this video helpful, and I'd love to hear your thoughts on the potential privacy ramifications, or any other implications that it might have. But so I'll post some more videos in the future on my thoughts as it begins to pull data, whether I notice any changes in my driving, knowing that certain driving habits are supposed to be able to reduce my premiums and all of that sort of thing. So stay posted for them. If you've liked the video, make sure you click the like, the thumbs up button, and share it with your friends. And if you subscribe by clicking here, you can get more of my videos as they are posted. Have a good one.